Do you also wonder why you should use a dual ball DBB design and not just a single ball DBB design? A single ball DBB design would be much cheaper. If yes, then this explainer video is made just for you. Well, basically, the answer is quite simple. It's all about safety and process reliability. Let us explain why. Just imagine that there are various single ball DBB valves installed in your plant. Some of them are in the open position. The toxic medium, which is under high pressure, flows through those valves. However, the medium is not pure. Hard particles like stones are part of the process medium too. During root maintenance work, the maintenance man notices that the single ball DBB valve is difficult to operate. Not giving much attention about the reason for this, he continues to try to operate the valve. Finally, the maintenance man is able to close the single ball DBB valve by 90 degrees. However, particles such as stones are jammed unnoticed between the ball and the seat. When this occurs, the jammed particles slowly destroy the ball surface and the upstream and/or downstream seat. As a consequence, leakage occurs at the outlet side of the closed single ball DBB valve. The toxic medium, which is under high pressure, escape unnoticed and cause an explosion. The damage is very serious. The maintenance man is seriously injured, the pipeline is destroyed, and the toxic gases cause environmental damage too. Let's look at what would happen if you had used a dual ball DBB valve in the same situation. Even if the primary ball valve leaks, the secondary ball valve remains tight, ensuring you a reliable process, healthy employees, and a clean environment. There you have it. The question of why you should use a dual ball DBB design and not just a single ball DBB design is answered. It's all about safety and process reliability.